Welcome back again children with a new video. Today we will learn new topic relationship between multiplication and division. As you have already learned in previous chapter, multiplication is repeated addition, but division is repeated subtraction. Okay, so here we will learn relationship between multiplication and division. So multiplication is repeated addition. Multiplication is repeated addition. Here, for example, two mangoes each for six people. To get two mangoes each for six people, what should we do here? We will add two. How many times? Six times. We will add two six times. 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 is equal to 12. How many times we have added here 2 repeatedly? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, because here 6 people. Okay, so 2 multiplied by 6 is equal to 12. Okay, we can write it another way. Yes, that we have already learned in previous chapter. Yes, but division is repeated subtraction. Yes. So look at here one example. To distribute 12 mangoes among two people. To distribute 12 mangoes among two people, what should we do here? We will subtract 2 from 12 again and again till we will not get 0. That also we have learned. Yes. So here we can write 12 minus 2 minus 2 minus 2 minus 2 again and again we will subtract 2 till we will not get 0. Okay, so for this, okay, in other way we can write this 12 divided by 2 is equal to 6, because here we have subtracted 2 how many times? 6 times. So our answer is 6. Yes, now look at here in multiplication. There are two multiplication facts for each division fact. There are two multiplication facts for division fact. Okay. For example, 12 divided by 2 is equal to 6. 12 divided by 2 is equal to 6 means 2 multiplied by 6 is equal to 12. When we will multiply these two numbers, 2 and 6, we will get this answer 12. 2 multiplied by 6 is equal to 12. Here is relationship between multiplication and division. Okay, look at here. 12 divided by 2 is equal to 6. Okay, so either we can write 2 multiplied by 6 is equal to 12 and 6 multiplied by 2 is also 12. We can change their order. That also we have learned in previous lesson, multiplication fact. We can change their order. Yes? Now, in division, there are two division facts for each multiplication fact. Children, there are two division facts for each multiplication fact. Look at here for example, 2 multiplied by 6. 2 multiplied by 6 is equal to 12 means 12 divided by 2 is equal to 6. When we will divide this 12 by 2, when we will divide this 12 by 2, we will get 6. Yes, and then if we will divide this 12 by this number 6, we will get this number 2. Okay, so here is two division fact for each multiplication. This is multiplication and these are two division fact. Understood? Now children, question number 5, complete the division and multiplication fact. We have to complete here multiplication and division fact. Okay, now children, look at here, 7 multiplied by dash is equal to dash. Here we have to fill what multiplication fact? Okay, because here is sign of multiplication. So this is multiplication, and we have already learned that every multiplication has two division fact. And what is the relationship between multiplication and division? Look at here. 21 divided by 7 is equal to 3. Now children, when we multiply these two numbers, okay, when we multiply these two numbers, we will get 21. 7 multiplied by 3 is equal to 21. Yes, or 7 threes are 21. Yes, one more division fact is here. 3 multiplied by 7 is equal to 21. 21 divided by 3 is equal to 7. And what is the relationship between multiplication and division? When we will multiply these two numbers, we will get this number. Okay? So, look at here. 7 is already given here. This one number is already given here. We have to find another number. We have to find another number. So, our another number is our second number is 3. It should be 3. 7 threes are 7 multiplied by 3 is equal to 21. Okay? 7 multiplied by 3 is equal to 21. 7 threes are 21, or 3 sevens are 21. Okay? Understood? Now, question B. 9 multiplied by 5 is equal to 45. Children, this is multiplication sign. Okay? So, it means this is multiplication, and we have already learned that every multiplication fact has two division fact. Okay? So, this is multiplication, and here we have to fill its two division fact. So, 9 multiplied by 5 is 45. What we have learned here? That when we divide this big number, that is 45, we will write here 45. When we will divide this 45 from this number, we will get this 9, another number. Okay? Yes, so 45 divided by 5 is equal to 49. Okay, 45 divided by 5 is equal to 9, which is another number, that is 9. So here we will write 45 divided by 9 is equal to 5. Children, we have already learned when we will multiply these two numbers, 9 and 5, we will get this big number, that is 45. Either we can write 9 multiplied by 5 is equal to 45, or 5 multiplied by 9 is 45. Got it? Now children, division facts. There are 5 division facts. So let's start. First one is, when we divide any number by 1, the answer is the number itself. When we divide any number by 1, when we divide any number by 1, the answer is the number itself. Okay? Like 9 divided by 1 is equal to 9. 3 divided by 1 is equal to 3. 4 divided by 1 is equal to 4. Like this. Okay? Now second, we cannot divide any number by 0. We can't divide any number by 0. Okay? Third one. When we divide any number by itself, the answer is 1. When we divide any number by itself, the answer is 1. Okay, like 5 divided by 5 is equal to 1. 2 divided by 2 is equal to by 10. Children, we can divide any number ending in 0. Which number? 0 is there in the end, like 40, 30, 50, 60, 70, 80, like this. Like 40 divided by 10 is equal to 4. Like 50 divided by 10 is equal to 5. Okay, here is 70. 70 divided by 10 is equal to 7. Means we can divide any number ending in 0 by 10. We can divide easily. Okay, question number 6. Divide the numbers. Children, these questions are based on division facts. Okay, so look at here. A, 9 divided by 9 is equal to dash, which is our third division fact, children. What is our third division fact? When we divide any number by the number itself, the answer is 1. Like 9 divided by 9 is equal to 1. Okay. Now, B, 24 divided by 1. Children, have you remembered our first division fact? What it says? Our first division fact is when we divide any number by 1, the answer is the number itself, 24. When we divide 24 by 1, the answer is the number itself. Okay? Now see, 20 divided by 10. We can divide any number ending in 0 by 10. So our answer is 2. Okay, 20 divided by 10 is equal to 2. Then D, 0 divided by 110 is equal to dash, which is our fourth division fact. Which is our fourth division fact, children? When we divide 0 by any number, the answer is 0. The answer is 0. So 0 divided by 110 is equal to 0. Okay? Now, question number 7. Fill in the boxes. Okay? So, we can do these questions according to division fact. Okay? So, look at here. A, 93 divided by dash is equal to 93. Children, we have already learned division facts. Yes? When we divide any number by 1, the answer is the number itself. So, here which number will come? 1. 93 divided by 1 is equal to 93. Okay? Next, B, dash divided by 1 is equal to 75. Children, when we divide any number by 1, the answer is the number itself. So, here is 75. When we divide 75 by 1, the answer is number itself. Okay? Next, C, 50 divided by dash is equal to 5. We can divide any number ending in 0 by 10. So here 10 will come. 50 divided by 10 is equal to 5. Okay, next, D, dash divided by 1 is equal to 375. That also we have already learned. Yes, when we divide any number, the answer is the number itself. Okay. Now children, our next topic, long division method. Children, long division method helps to divide bigger number easier. So, look at here for example, 21 divided by 7. What should we do first? First we will write here, 21 divided by 7. So, this is dividend, this is called dividend. This is called dividend, the number is to be divided. Okay, and this 7, this is called divisor. This is divisor, the number by which we divide. Okay? What should we do? First, 7 is here. From this number we will divide 21. Yes? We will recite 7th table. Okay? Till 21 will come. Okay? So, 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14, 7 threes are 21. 7 threes are 21. Okay? This 21 we will write below this 21, then subtract here. Okay? 1 minus 1, 0. 2 minus 2, 0. Okay? And this 3, 7 threes are 21. This 3 is called quotient. Okay? And the 0, this is our remaining. This is our remaining. Okay? The answer we get is quotient. Okay? So, 21 divided by 7 is equal to 3. This answer is quotient. Okay? So, this 21 is dividend. This 7 is divisor. The answer we get is quotient and 0 is remaining. Understood? Now, children, question number 8. Divide and find the quotient. Here, we have to find the quotient. Okay? So, children, in long division method, what should we do? Here, this is our dividend. The number is to be divided. Is called dividend. And this 2 is the divisor. Divisor, the number by which we divide. Yes? And the answer we get is called quotient. So, how many times this 2 goes to 14? 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 2 threes are 6, 2 fours are 8, 2 fives are 10, 2 sixes are 12, 2 sevens are 14. So, 2 sevens are 14. Yes, this 7 we will write here and this 14. 2 sevens are 14. Okay, we will write this 14 below this number. Yes, then subtract here 4 minus 4, 0. Then 1 minus 1, 0. Understood? Now, children, when we will do long division method, if this number is not comes in the table of 2, so what we will do? Then we will take the smaller number from 14 which comes in the table of 2. Okay? But here 14 comes. So, as it is, we have taken. Okay? If it is not come, then we will do like that. Okay? Now, move to the next question. 25 divided by 5. Here is, this 25 is dividend and this one is divisor. So, we have to recite the table of 5 till we will not get 25. So, how many times this 5 goes to 25? 5 is a 5, 5 2 is a 10, 5 3 is a 15, 5 4 is a 20 and 5 5 is a 25. 5 5s are 25. This 5 we will write here and this 25 we will write below this number. So, 5 5s are 25. Then subtract here 5 minus 5, 0. Then 2 minus 2 is 0. Then our quotient is 5. Understood? Now, 81 divided by 9. So, here this is dividend and this one is divisor. Okay? So, we have to recite here the table of 9 till we will get 81. So, 9 9s are 81. This 81 we have to write this below this 81. Okay, 9 9s are 81. Then subtract here 1 minus 1, 0. Then 8 minus 8, 0. Okay, so this 9 is our quotient. Yes? Now, F. 56 divided by 7. Children, here we of 7. Okay, then we will get 56. Yes, so how many times we have to recite the table of 7? Then we get 56. 7 8s are 56. 7 8s are 56. Okay, 8 we will write here. 7 8s are and 56 we will write below this number. Okay, then subtract here 6 minus 6, 0. Then 5 minus 5, 0. So, this 8 is our quotient. Yes, understood? Children, we will meet in next video. Till then, do practice at your home and stay fit. Thank you.